Yeah, hello, my name is Christian Wolter from Trade Wohler, and like every week now we want to present you some interesting stocks from the US market where we saw like unusual call or put volume or some news what might be interesting for every investor. We would like to start with the symbol CLDR. You have to take a really detailed look to see the real price here from $16. The stock itself jumped 24% overnight, and the news here was not only the earnings what was published or like what came out before the market opened today, it was also here the news that CLDR will be purchased by another company, and that's now the movement what we have already in the news. How much money for how much money the stock should be bought. So from this point of view, I think it's a good base that the stock will keep this level of $16. But to move really higher at the moment, I mean, we saw a few call and put options, but this can be also something what people where people close their positions. But CLDR definitely a very interesting stock for the next weeks to keep an eye on it, especially when it comes closer to the deal that the company, what is their main business, software or cloud service, like the name Cloudera Incorporation already mentioned it, can be really interesting for the next few weeks. But other than this, we also have a few more stocks for you, for example AHT, where we can see at the moment also almost 20% in profit, and especially if you start here from the end of April where the stock was around $2 and now moved already up to almost $5, you would say when I just consider this range, I don't think there's much more to go up, but I think here it's very important to have a more detailed view on a longer time frame. Of course, what we see here is everything related to the Corona crisis, but even then last summer the stock moved in a very short move in 4 days from $7 almost up to $18. And I think this is from the uptrend itself, comparing to what we had here, really a stable and solid uptrend with a big potential. And the big fact here is now the call volume, what is really pushing this stock. The stock itself with the symbol AHT comes from hotel or motel business, and from the news itself, there was not much what we can see here, especially on Finviz. Maybe in the next days there will be some more news, but I think $5 is a very interesting level, and most of the bets what we saw today was of course that it goes above $5, or then the next big target $7.50, and what we can already see in the last months, it can easily go up in a few days even to this level, and even after all the up movement what we already saw in the past few months. Then another very interesting stock, mainly also here pushed by Reddit at the moment, even you can't see it if I just show you here the stock itself. You really have to have a look here. It's at the moment almost 7% in profit, but this is a good sign, because in the percentage wise, or even if we have a look in the volume itself, it's almost triple than the normal volume. So this can be something what's at the beginning of a longer up movement, and mainly here we also had targets like almost like $5. And we know which potential advice from Reddit can have. We saw it with many different symbols in the last few months, that 100% in a few days is yeah, it's possible, and it's normally, I would say, almost the average from all the trades what we had here. So this is something what is not moving so fast, so strong. So it's definitely something for the watch list what you can have a look in a later period of time. But other than this, I think we also mentioned this in one of our last videos. So to not miss any of these videos, please subscribe here to our channel to see exactly something like SNDL, where we had a short video in the last week. Here we can see the reason. It started with a great call volume where it was also pushed in the price. Last week we spoke about the $1. The $1 level was already reached on Friday. This Monday there was a holiday in the US, so Tuesday was the first trading day. Today it moved again a little bit higher, but I think when we see this up movement with the call volume, it's much better than what I said also in the previous stock than something what goes up 100 or 50% in 2 days, because then it's really risky. It can go down in the same speed, even faster than it moved up. And here I would say we are still in the beginning. Even when we see it percentage wise, a few days ago the stock was like around 72 cents, so the stock already moved up a 50%. But if you see it in the past, there's a great potential. Maybe something like February, I think. This is exactly what I was talking about. It's too fast, too high, but if this stock will go to $1.50 or $2 in the next few weeks, this can be really realistic, and maybe this was the beginning of a great up movement what we saw here in SNDL. And it's not only interesting for option trading, it can be also a very interesting stock for your stock portfolio. Another very small stock was ANG. ANG, you can see it here with a really significant call volume. Mainly we had bets here that ANG can reach, ENG can reach the $5 level. The name is EN Global Corporation, and same like what we had here. It's a small stock. It's a symbol what we don't have very often in our scanning tools, but I think it's really realistic for the next 2-3 weeks that we can reach the $5 level. And the same, it's the beginning, so keep an eye on it. If you can see further movements in the direction of the $5, it can be really an interesting investment. Or also at the moment, just with a stop maybe here around $2, so you also have a very nice chance risk ratio, for example. But other than these small stocks what we saw here, then we also have two very big companies what everyone knows. One of these companies is ExxonMobil with the symbol XOM. Here we can see the chart in the background for ExxonMobil, and I think on one hand side is a strong oil price at the moment. The down movement what we had here after the last not all-time high but 52-week high was also related to the ex-dividend date. That's why also we see here so many call options, because everyone who had a call option in the money normally assigns it before ex-dividend date to make sure to also receive the dividends itself. So now it might be interesting if ExxonMobil can reach again the highest price here, especially with the support here around $58. Very interesting trade for maybe a credit put spread, 58, 57, for example. So ExxonMobil, not with a massive call volume, but still very interesting chart. Also with the volume what we see here in the last few days. Other than ExxonMobil, we have NIO. Also something what you know from the past few months, because here we have to go back a little bit more. Neo really went went up more than 1000%, I think, in the last year, even more than this, I think. And now after it reached its all-time high above $65, it lost almost 50% of its price. And what we saw in the last 2-3 months, I would say, is a new support level here around $32. Today, Citigroup announced an upgrade or an update of the new price target. And for me now, the next two important prices is the last local high and also here the price level of $45, because if it's moving above the $45, then we can even see in the next few months maybe a new all-time high. But it was important to have this support here, and now with the volume and the chart, like it looks like exactly like this W, we can easily see $50-$55 in the next few months. So yeah, if you don't want to miss any of the next videos, feel free to subscribe to our channel. I would be happy to welcome you again. Stay safe and see you soon.